In this lecture, we will learn how to treat different inequalities in graphical solution in the two minimization type of graphical solution of a linear programming problem. This is a problem we have directly have taken problem. This is a minimization type of problem. So we will consider inequality, different inequality. Look at here, lesser than this constraint is a lesser than type and this constraint is greater than type. In such a case, how to address this type of constraint, how to draw diagram in graphical solution, you will continue on today. So we have Z minimization 3x plus 4 2y and we have two decision variable, hence we can go for graphical solution. So as you know already, I have removed inequalities, I have removed inequality and converted into equality, that I have removed lesser than or greater than type 2 just to find two interval point in each constraint. Okay, x minus y equals to 1 and x plus y equals to 3, x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. Now let us find the two points for each constraint. For that I will consider first constraint. This first constraint I will consider this. And when x is equal to 0, what is y? We have to find out what is y. Very importantly, you want to look into this equation, that x minus y, x has positive value, y has negative value, very importantly. And when you consider x is 0, y would be y equals to this, since 1y, my minus 1y is there, since so it would be y is equal to 1 minus minus 1, because y already having minus 1 value, so this value would be minus 1. So when x is equal to 0, y is minus 1. And if you take the reverse action, when y is equal to 0, what is x? Since x is having positive value, x is equal to 1 by 1, so 1 by 1 is 1. X value is 1 when y is 0 and y value is minus 1 when x is 0. And I will consider second constraint. I will consider second constraint to find two points, so that it will help to draw a graph in a graphical solution. So x plus y equals to 0. When x is equal to 0, so look at here, x and y only one y, one and one x. Since 1y and 1x, you can take x a, when x is 0, y would be 3. When y is 0, x would be 3. So it is in the sense x equal to 3 by 1, because x has one x. Okay, so same thing will happen to y also. This is the way you will find the values, so two points for the constraint after removing inequalities. Then let us plot graph for first constraint. I am considered first constraint two points. When x is equal to 0, y is minus 1. When y is equal to 0, x is 1. Okay, so let us find the value. X is 0 and y is minus 1. This is the point. X is 0, y is minus 1, x is 0 here, and second point, x is 1, y is 0, x is 1, y is 0. Okay, so these two points we have to make join together. These two points will join each other. Okay, and now let us go for a second constraint, two points. In the second constraint also we have two points, x, when x is 0, y is 3, when y is 0, x is 3. Then let us point out these two points in the graph. When x is 0, y is 3. When x is 0, y is 3. When y is 0, x is 3. Now let us join these two points together. So I have joined two points of second constraint. So this is first constraint, as you know already. This is first constraint and this one is second constraint. Second constraint, very importantly. And to find reason, you need to concentrate on inequalities. Okay, first constraint inequality is lesser than or equal to type. Very importantly, lesser than or equal to type. Second constraint inequality is greater than or equal to type. You should take the problem, the given problem in that inequality. So to fulfill inequality, as per condition only, you need to move on. Okay, so this is a special case, but because if you fulfill the inequality of first constraint, that is lesser than or equal to type, it will deviate the second constraint that guidelines, that in the case rule, because second constraint has having greater than or equal to type, but first constraint having lesser than or equal to type. If you draw this, like look at here, if you draw this completely lesser than or equal to type, it will deviate to second constraint. Very importantly, it will deviate to second constraint, in the sense, so here second constraint is this, the it should not be a lesser than or equal to type, it should be a greater than or equal to type. So to consider finally feasible reason, you cannot consider this because both constraint equalities must be fulfilled. Okay, if I draw second constraint values in the table, look at here, second constraint could have to be shaded like this, because this is the reason in which second constraint is coming. That it means greater than equal to, greater than, whatever the greater than, but here it should also be become greater than. But if you draw greater than to this second constraint, it will deviate first constraint value, that is a lesser than or equal to. So what we will do is, so look at here, we have to draw like this for second constraint. Second constraint we have to draw like this. So this is not permittable, because if you draw first constraint reason, it will deviate second constraint reason. If you draw second constraint reason completely, it will deviate first constraint reason. Okay, so you have to consider what is permissible. Okay, so in this scenario, what is the basic, what could be the basic feasible solution by fulfilling both two types of a constraint inequality, means this. So this is a basic feasible this is the feasible solution and feasible reason where you will have solution for this problem. So which means we have to find, after drawing a feasible reason, we have to find the corner points. So look at here, corner points, as I told you before, it is a point where two intersection meet together, which means this is in this point two intersection are taking place, in this point also two axes are meeting together, so it is an intersection. So in this case we have only two points, that's a and b for solution. Okay, so what is the power value of a in the a, x, this curve x is 2 and y is 1. And what about this point, x is 0 y is 3. Okay, so this is the two points, and based on these two points we can calculate the corner power. So we obtain two corner points from the graphs, that corner point a and corner point b, after finding out feasible reason from that graph. So in the corner point a, x is 2 y is 1, and in the corner point b, x is 0 y is 3. So we will apply these two corner point values to the objective function of the problem. So it is a z minimization case objective function. So objective function is z minimization, 3x plus 2y. So 3, the x value in that corner point is 2, 3 into 2, and y value is 2 in the objective function, but in the corner point it is 1. So 3 into 2, 6, 2 into 1, 2. So 6 plus 2, 8. In the corner point a, the value is 8, and in the corner point b, x is 0, y is 3. So 2 into 3, 6, 3 into 0, 0, plus 2 into 3, 6. So this corner point B value is 6. So with comparison of two corner points, the minimization, our objective function is to minimize the cost, time, whatever. Based on that, we will go for this corner point B. So at corner point B, you will find optimum solution according to the scenario and given problem, for the given problem.